Alright, I already got my running around done. Scrapyard Bank Post Office. Scrapyard Bank, in that order too. In that order. So I think I left here at 9:30. And it is 11:20, so that ain't bad. Oh, Lord. So, let's do a quick thing here. So, Brightwire was 57 pounds. He gave me 375 a pound. It's actually like 370 at the other yard, so 213.75. Number two copper, 116 pounds at 360 a pound. It's 350 at the other yard, so he gave me a little bump up there as well. So that was 417.60. And copper transformers, 412 pounds, 30 cents a pound for 123, for a total of 754.95. And then I spent, $53 for some electronics and a couple of the appliance wires. Those two crapples I didn't want, I ended up with those. So, we got a crapple on the bottom. I'm not sure what this thing is here. It's got some boards in it. I'm hoping they're decent. Another computer there. Another crapple there. A PCI card, video card. Some Rambus memory. More Rambus memory. Cell phone. And a couple of cords. That was it. That's all I wanted to deal with. I didn't want to buy anything because he said trying to keep my money so I can pay my bills. So I got this receipt and I got that's how bad it's getting. So I don't really want to do that, but if stuff don't start picking up here, like I said, I'm going to be in a world of hurt. And I still have some big debts to pay off. So, not sure what's going to happen. So, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. And these boards here are crap. They're integrated boards, so they don't really pay nothing. Maybe 70 cents a pound, so they're 70 cents. I don't think I have one. Clean one. Do I? I don't think I do. No. But they're kind of like these. That's an integrated board right there. So that's what's in those. For as big as they are. So they probably have a couple pieces of RAM. And that's it. But for board sort, I have some CD cards. CD-ROM cards. A couple pieces of backplane board. A little bit of low peripheral, a little bit of high peripheral, a couple pounds of finger cards, mid-grade, high telecom, and low telecom. So that's it. That's all there is. So I might not end up back at board store till August or September. These are high telecom here, but you know, that's only, I think those are only a couple bucks a piece. This has to go through. Most of this is mid-grade though. Same with that. That's yokes and stuff in there, so. Yeah, it's not good. I took the post office box that was for a board sort. That was I-Series. I threw some, I think 3 or 4 pounds of memory in there. Some Rambus memory. Some odds and ends, P4 metal CPUs. I don't know what else was in there. Oh, my tantalums. I had 3 or 4 pounds of tantalums. Got rid of those. I'm not even going to pull them off the boards anymore. So that was my tantalum bucket, which is now filled with dirt. So, yeah. Oh, and I got that for board sort, which is connector ends, the adapters, I got that tote, and then I have a bigger tote here. I don't know if these are 15 or 25 cents a pound, but there's like 70 pounds in here. So I think what I'm gonna do is probably go through some of these today and just pop all these off. These little, whatever you want to call these damn things. But these come off really easy. Anyway, so you just pry them up. They're a little thick though, but just snap those off. So I can snap that one off, that one off, that one off, and then flip it over and hit it with the brick hammer, and this copper piece will come off. And then just, when I get a bunch of these, then I'll just go back and heat them up and get that little board off the inside of them. And I'll have more copper. So, like I said, this was, before I started even doing these, this was over 300 pounds of copper right here. So, there's still probably, I'd say at least 180 pounds, 200 pounds maybe there. Just between those two totes. I can't pick that bottom one up. And I still have all the aluminum to do. Super muggy today. So, got me breathing heavy. So I'm just gonna take some of this stuff here, this wire, put that in some of them cans, get that inside, get this cleaned up a little bit here, and see what I can get going here. So, and I noticed I hit the 3,100 subscribers. I think it's 3,101 actually, so appreciate that. I'm not one for numbers, but it's still cool to see. Still cool to see. So yeah, I don't even know if I'm gonna be hanging out here today, because like I said, it is like super super muggy. I mean, the air is heavy as hell, so I don't really feel like being out here panting like a dog. And I lost my ink pen. And I found a better way to do these, because I use the air hammer or that fork on these. Some of them will pull right out. You know, I use this thing here. So, some of them will pull out, but if they don't pull out, I flip them over. And I just take this flat one and just run this through them. And it pushes them all out and knocks them out. So, it takes a little bit more time, but it gets them out of there. It does get them out. So, yep. So, I'm going to fill out that application like I said, if things don't pick up, I'm just going to have to go and put all this on the side and just go work full time. I don't really know what else to do. And like I said, the inventory is terrible. I actually had another guy that I was selling my, or buying laptops from and selling him laptops. And he called me the other day and I told him, I said, the inventory is... it's gone. I mean, there's nothing anywhere. I said, you know, and what's there is not enough to go pick up because it'll cost you more to go get it than, you know, what it's worth. He's like, yes. He said, you're not the first person to tell me that. So it's not just me. It's pretty much everywhere. And like I said, the yard furthest out has probably 2 Gaylord boxes of computers, but you know, it's probably only 30 computers, and to go all the way out there, it's S-U-R-A-P. It's really not worth it. It, you know, costs me more for fuel and help than, you know, what it's worth to go out there and pick that crap up. So, I usually wait till they have at least 3 or 4 boxes, but right now, funds are, you know, I wouldn't even be able to get it off them anyway. Because I'm trying to keep my bills paid and a roof over my head. So, that is that. Oh, here's some more of these out here. So I can pop these all off. These are all copper too. Cool. Some more ice cubes. Board sort buys these. I'm not going to take these apart. I know some of you knuckleheads do, but not this guy. I got rid of all those computer cases yesterday. I threw them all in my garbage can. I think I had 6 of them, and I put 2 in each can. I have 3 trash cans. So those went bye-bye this morning at about 7 o'clock. So got rid of that mess. And, yeah. Like I said, I'm, it looks like there's a lot laying around here. There's really not. And I fixed my window. But there's really not a lot laying around here. It's more low-paced stuff than, you know, anything else. It's either breakage or shred mostly. There's some boards here that have some memory and stuff on them. So, just add that to the next pile, I guess. So, alright guys, I'm gonna go in the house and sit down and ponder my life here for 2 minutes. And here, I found my pen. Woohoo! And decide whether I want to come out here and deal with the humidity. And kill myself or sit in the house and run up my electric bill with the central air. Yeah. Good lord. So yeah, that wasn't a bad 754. It only took me a couple days to do. So that wasn't too bad. So with that, I'm going to say appreciate y'all. Stay safe. Keep doing what you're doing. And hopefully I can find some stuff and get things turned around, because I really don't want to have to go work a full-time job. Oh yeah, and I got that the other day. So, talk to y'all later.